Probably should have filmed this f before I put the glue in, but basically it was just a headstock brake where it's just tilted forward but still attached from the face. So you just saturate it with glue and then clamp it up. I'm gonna get more clamps on here, but this is like some of the process. And I'm gonna wipe some of that nasty squeeze out off before that dries and get more clamps on it. So at this point, condition is not really a problem. So normal practice is you don't put clamps on straight to the instrument, but this is not its first break, and I don't know if I can get a good, yeah, I don't know if it'll show, but actually it's broke before in another spot. And that spot is still intact. It's just, it's now broken another spot. Okay, so you can see where the glue is squeezing out, but right above it is this other line, right? If I can get it to focus. There we go. It's so zoomed in, I'm trying to stay stable here. There we go. That dark line that you see over the squeeze out, that's the previous break. And that's still intact. Yeah, that dark line that you're seeing across. That's the previous break, so it has broke before, but it stayed intact. It's just, if you do this properly, by clamping and letting it cure, that joint is stronger than the wood around it. So if it breaks again, it's going to break somewhere else. And now it's just layered. This is the Les Paul that has this problem. It's going to be fine later. I'm going to fix those pickup rings too. There's no springs where the screws are, and that one's upside down. So like I was saying before, so at the very end, where all this dried up squeeze out is, here, and it run, you can almost not see it, it runs this way, this direction, over here. And then you can see on top of that was like a previous break, right here. It's darker. It's going here, basically. When it's repaired properly, that glue joint is stronger than the wood around it. And that's the case because now it broke somewhere else. It doesn't make it any weaker. Just if it took a big impact, it might snap somewhere else. So that yellow spot is what looks like filler from the previous job. And all I'm doing right here is, in this little area right here, it was kinda gapped. So I'm just filling it with super glue. So at least there's not a crater. And then it kinda helps seal this part. It's not gonna help with structure or anything, but it just creates just a seal, almost like a clear coat. Alright, gap's filled, it's now dry, and technically I could do some sanding or whatever to make it all nice, but honestly, it's been broken twice. It's really just a seal. It's not too bad. Not really going to feel it, you're going to be playing more over here, so I'm going to call it good, and then get this thing set up. And technically this thing would be able to hold probably even 11s in standard, but I usually do 10 to 52, but this is a customer, so the customer wants 10s, which is just as good. So I'd say this turned out successful. There's the creasing that you can see from the bending, but didn't come clean off. Holding standard 10s. The action's not bad. It's about 40 to 50 thousandths of an inch.